We don't have time for a meeting of the Flat Earth Society. We're trying to move towards the future. They want to be stuck in the past. And we've heard this kind of thinking before. Let me tell you something. If some of these folks were around when Columbus set sail, they must have been founding members of the Flat Earth Society. They would not have believed that the world was round.
Is Matt Boylan. AKA Matthew Leonard Boylan. AKA Dragonfly Supervisor. Agent N2's ZX10. Graphics Operational Manager for NASA. I've been a comedian for about 20 years, it's been a front. I'm a hireless painter, photorealist painter. Worked for NASA on and off doing freelance graphics for about 20 years now. In the quirk in the second atom of the quasar and the black hole. NASA. As you can see, we got a nice red serpent tongue coming through there. NASA. And there's the UN flag. Also the symbol of the flat earth. Oh, of course, if I say flat earth, I gotta be an idiot, right? That's what they told you, right? It's a ball. There's no Antarctica in this. It's a bird's eye over the North Pole. Right in your fucking face. You know, there's gonna be some comedians making jokes tonight, but I want to talk about the joke that's on you.
A group of social criminals, these people in the space program, nassholes, I call them. In case you haven't heard, the latest disaster for the rest of the universe is that the United States is going to go to Mars, okay? Oh, yeah. We're going to go to Mars. And then, of course, we're going to colonize deep space with our microwave hot dogs and plastic vomit, fake dog shit and cinnamon dental floss and lemon-scented toilet paper and sneakers with lights in the heels. And all these other impressive things we've done down here. But let me ask you this. What are we going to tell the Intergalactic Council of Ministers the first time one of our teenage mothers throws her newborn baby into a dumpster, huh? How are we going to explain that to the space people? How are we going to let them know that our ambassador was only late for the meeting because his breakfast was cold and he had to spend half an hour punching his wife around the kitchen? And what are they going to think when they find out it's just a local custom that over 80 million women in the third world have had their clitorises forcibly removed in order to reduce their sexual pleasure so they won't cheat on their husbands? Can't you just sense how eager the rest of the universe is for us to show up? Can't you see them out there?
Oh, this is amazing. We just went to Mars. Hey, big round of applause, man, for the Americans going to Mars. And this is the official image of them landing there. Fucking funny. It's like, isn't it amazing how they were landing there and they already had an airbrush artist with his easel set up to paint it land that quick? It's like unbelievable. I don't even think this is real. This is the official landing. Oh, then they got another one with a metal sort of pipe and sand in black and white. That's proof. They were there, man. They're landing on the sand. Check it out. That's it. There you go, some more images. This is what they're doing on Mars right now. Moving around with their little rover. That's a real photo, look at that. This is another. I swear to God, they're on Mars right now. Look at that. This thing's moving around, I don't even know what it does. It's like a weird sort of sample collector. It's a spider. It's a spider sample sampler. It's a spider sampler. Sand sampler. It's a sand sampler. They call it.
It's getting spice.
It's getting spices from Mars. Yeah. Go to the next one. They're on Mars. That's unbelievable.
There it is. There's your world. You know when they took that? 1969. First lunar mission to the moon. You know, the first lunar mission to the moon wasn't so much about going to the moon. It was about having an event so you can go high enough to take a picture after 500 years to prove it was a ball. They went to the moon before they crossed the Antarctic. The two most watched televised events in history, the moon landing and the towers falling. Up. Down. Most people saw the lunar landing and they swear on it because they heard it on the radio. CBS put up screens all over in Central Park, along with NBC, you know, so they could work with groupthink dynamics. Reality is reinforced by group dynamics, witnessing an event.
People are fucking dumb. You can say what you want about this country, and I love this place. I love the freedoms we used to have. I love it. I love that. You know? I love it when it didn't take a fucking catastrophe to get us to care for one another. I love the fact that we're on camera all the time from all angles. But you know what? You can say what you want about America. And I say, I love this place. I wouldn't have it any other way. Wouldn't live in any other time in history in any other place. But say what you want about America, land of the free, home of the brave. We got some dumbass motherfuckers floating around this country. Dumbass motherfuckers. You know? Yeah. Now, obviously, that doesn't include this audience. I understand that. You seem intelligent and perceptive, but the rest of them, holy jumping fucking shitballs. Dumber than a second coat of paint. And this ain't just ranting and raving. This ain't just blowing off steam. I got a little evidence to support my claim. It just seems to me, that only a really low IQ population could have taken this beautiful continent, this magnificent American landscape that we inherited. Well, actually, we stole it from the Mexicans and the Indians, but hey, it was nice when we stole it. It looked pretty good. It was pristine. Paradise. Have you seen it lately? Have you taken a good look at it lately? It's fucking embarrassing. Only a nation of unenlightened half-wits could have taken this beautiful place and turned it into what it is today, a shopping mall. A big fucking shopping mall. You know that? That's all you got. That's all you've got here, folks. Mile after mile of mall after mall. Many, many malls. Major malls and mini malls. They put the mini malls in between the major malls. And in between the mini malls, they put the mini marts. And in between the mini marts, you got the car lots, gas stations, muffler shops, laundromats, cheap hotels, fast food joints, strip clubs, and dirty bookstores. America the Beautiful. One big transcontinental commercial cesspool. And how do the people feel about all this? How do the people feel about living in a coast-to-coast shopping mall? Well, they think it's just fucking dandy. They think it is cool as can be because Americans love the mall. They love the mall. That's where they get to satisfy their two most prominent addictions at the same time, shopping and eating. Millions of semi-conscious Americans day after day shuffling through the malls, shopping and eating, especially eating. Americans love to eat. They are fatally attracted to the slow death of fast food. Hot dogs, corn dogs, triple bacon, cheeseburgers, deep fried butter dipped in pork fat and cheese whiz, mayonnaise soaked, barbecued mozzarella, patty melts. Americans will eat anything. If you were selling sauteed raccoons' assholes on a stick, Americans would buy them and eat them. These people, These people are efficient, professional, compulsive consumers. That's their, they think of that as their national pride. It's their civic duty, consumption. It's the new national pastime. Fuck baseball, it's consumption. The only true, lasting American value that's left, buying things. Buying things. People spending money they don't have on things they don't need. Money they don't have on things they don't need. So they can max out their credit cards and spend the rest of their lives paying 18% interest on something that costs $12.50. And they didn't like it when they got it home anyway. Not too bright, folks. Not too fucking bright.
Here's like a perfect example of them landing on the moon. I mean, it's proof right there. This is an official NASA photo of the first Apollo 11 lunar module landing on the moon. I mean, it's right there. This is the proof, man. It's the pictures right there. It's landing on the moon. But the only problem I have with this picture is that it's taken from the moon. I don't know what the big deal was with being the first guy on the moon. It seems the camera crew was already there. The fucking tripod. Camera A, B, C. You know, back in the 60s, I mean, I know people who believe they saw the landing on the moon because they heard it on the radio. Don't get in here, they're on the moon, I can hear the dust. My God, I can hear him walk. He's walking slow. There's zero gravity up there. Jesus, they're on there now. They're on there now. I could just see a guy in a sound studio just taking fucking, like a bag of salt going, landing on the wooden floor and just going, oh my God, they're there. They're on it right now. Ethel, get in here. Like, how would you know? There was no independent telescope to even like say they went to the moon. The only telescopes that I could actually film it were NASA telescopes. Yeah, according to the people who landed on the moon, they landed on the moon. Nobody else could fucking check it out. So there it is. That's a fucking photo. There it is landing for the first time, but how? How? Next photo. It's funny how NASA gives us these little pictures, eh? Every week there's a little NASA photo, what they're up to, just to keep you fucking nursing off the teat.
Well, this is my take on it. I am not saying that I have any information that anybody else doesn't have. I'm not saying that I know that we didn't land on the moon. I'm not saying that I know that everyone's a liar. I'm not saying that it was a total hoax. All I'm saying is when I look at all of it, when I look at the photographic evidence, or I look at the fact that we haven't been back since 1972, when I look at the fact that no humans except the Apollo astronauts have ever gone through the Van Allen radiation belt, the fact that no one's even done a flyby around the moon since then, it seems weird to me. When I look at the press conference and I see Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong and Michael Collins nervous and weird and obviously like being deceptive after they came back, I go, what is that? I look at all that stuff. When I look at the video footage that Bart Siegel character, who's clearly out of his mind, for sure. And so is that Renee guy, and so are a lot of those guys. But sometimes, occasionally, someone who's clearly out of their mind has a point. If you can sift through all their BS and look at all the crap that they say and run it through a filter, every now and then they'll say something, oh, well, this guy's wrong about almost everything, but is he wrong about that? Now, when I look at that video and some of the video that Siegel has of them faking the distance between the Earth and the Moon, when they're shooting the Moon, or the Earth rather, through a circular window in the lunar module, and they have the windows blacked out, they're pretending that it's deep space, they're saying that they're 130,000 miles out, and then you see them pull the window curtains down, or the shade, whatever they have covering up with the windows, and you see that they're actually in near-Earth orbit, that makes me curious. When I look at the photographs and I see intersecting shadows. Now, I'm no photographic expert. I don't know anything about the moon, really, except stuff that I've read on the internet. I'm no scientist. But when I see intersecting shadows that seem to show some sort of a different light source or more than one light source, it looks odd to me. When I see that those crosshairs aren't over all the images, it looks cut and cropped to me. When I look at some of the photographs of the moon, I have this gigantic coffee book, coffee table book, and it's all, you know, a NASA book, and it's beautiful pictures of the moon and all these different photographs. Well, when I look at some of them, they look obviously fake. They look cut and cropped. And I'm not saying I know they are. I'm not saying I have any special information. But I'm an open-minded person, and when I look at it, I say, look, I know I sound like a retard. I know I sound like a crackpot. I know saying that, you know, the Earth is hollow. There's dinosaurs inside of it. I'm sure. It's very similar to saying I don't think people landed on the moon. But you know what? I don't think people landed on the moon.
No human being ever since the Apollo astronauts has gone more than 400 miles up.
That's about right, yeah.
That's ridiculous. 260,000 miles there and back, and the best they can do since 1972 is 400 miles?
Yeah. And now, while you're saying it's ridiculous because you can't believe it, I think it's ridiculous because I can believe it very well.
But there's it's not like they're not spending money. And they keep talking about going back, but they talk about going back in 2020. Why go back in 2020 when you could just... That's the other problem. They don't have the telemetry data from the Apollo 11. Isn't that like the most important data? Isn't that like the most important thing? A huge technological achievement. They landed a man on the moon, brought him back, and they're missing the telemetry data? 14,000 something reels?
They're missing... A lot of that stuff was not...
Because you can't fake it. You can't fake the telemetry data.
One of the things that's most irritating about this conspiracy theory for someone like me is that a lot of this stuff is really subtle and complicated. And
14,000 reels of telemetry data for the most technological achievement in human history that's not stored in the Smithsonian Institute, it's not stored in NASA vault, it's not labeled, it's not under lock and key, it's not in a gold vault. There's nothing weird about that.
I can't say anything about 14,000 reels. I don't know the number. And so,
yeah, it's,
you know,
it's like 13,000 or 14,000. I forget.
Either
way, it's more than 100, which is crazy. You've lost more. If you lost more than 100 of the telemetry data, that's insane.
A lot of the stuff was owned by contractors. It was shelved. They weren't paid to store it. And
it's NASA.
Away.
It's NASA. NASA lost it. This is the hard footage.
NASA is not just NASA. NASA is civil servants. NASA is 10 different contractors. There was Northrop Grumman. There was North American.
Nice. Yeah,
there
Grumman lost all their stuff.
Guys.
So did Boeing. They lost all their information, too, on the moon buggy, on the lunar module. They lost all that stuff.
This is
how
this
convenient.
Is it's another argument brought up by conspiracy theorists. Not to me. Each one of these missions, each one of these lunar landers was different. It's not like they designed a car and then just cranked them out. They had an overall design, and then each one was different. Each one, they had to note all of these changes and everything, and it was all done on paper.
I gotta tell you, Phil, I'm not done with you, bitch. We haven't even gotten into solar flares. The apex of a 20-year solar cycle happened while the Apollo landings were going on. Those people would have fried up there, baby.
This is Rocky. This is Rocky joking, not half a chance. Joe is holding his own. Yes, there has to be another installment. Joe Rogan, Phil Plait, CBS Radio. This is Ben Gillette.
If I went for NASA, I'd fire you, bro.
Speaking of flying through space, you don't think the moon landing is real?
No, I don't. No. Do you?
Yeah.
Why do you think the moon landing is real? Why don't you tell me why?
I saw it on television.
Oh, you're a f-ing genius. Oh, beep that.
We'll bleep it. No, it's okay. We got
That's genius. You saw it on TV? That's awesome. I'm going to show you some CGI. I'm going to show you King Kong. I saw that on TV, too. This is an 80-foot gorilla. He's running around kidnapping white chicks. You should check it out. 1972 was the last time a human being has been through the Van Allen radiation belt. 1972. That's the last time. There's been only 7 trips ever that human beings have ever gone past 400 miles. Every single space station mission, every space shuttle, every satellite, all of those are inside the protective Van Allen radiation belts, which started 1,000 miles. They go from 1,000 miles to, depending on who you ask, if you ask NASA, 24,000 miles. If you ask James Van Allen, the guy who discovered it, it's 67,000 miles of intense radiation that's in a gigantic donut band that covers around the Earth. Now, even if you got outside of that band, you have to deal with solar cycles. There's the apex of a 20-year solar cycle was between 1969 and 1972. All the time when these guys are making those missions. Any one of those guys out there in those tiny little aluminum-shielded crafts would have been killed instantly during any solar flare.
Why fake it?
Thank you, Kyle.
Why not fake it?
You should open with that.
If you look at any of the footage online, it looks ridiculous. It looks stupid. If you look at the videos, it looks ridiculous and dumb. You know why? Because in 1969, nobody anticipated that we were going to have VCRs and the internet. We were going to be able to watch that. They figured out a way to fake it. That's why when Neil Armstrong got back, first of all, he went insane. They went into a deep depression. So did Buzz Aldrin. He became a huge alcoholic. He gave no interviews. Neil Armstrong still to this day will not give interviews. He gave one speech that he gave at the 25th anniversary of the moon landing. And this is what he said in front of America's best honor students. He said, "We have here amongst us America's best and brightest." And the quote was, "You will achieve many great things if you could peel away one of truth's hidden layers." That's a speech this guy gives standing in front of the top honor students of the country. Not, "I went to the moon." He doesn't say that. He gives this cryptic speech. Now, Bill Clinton, in page 100, I think it's 156 of his book, My Life, he gives this story about how when he was a kid, he was working with this carpenter. And this carpenter said, "You know, I don't believe man landed on the moon." It was 3 months after the moon landing. And he said, "I thought that guy was ridiculous." He said, "You know what? I don't believe anything those TV fellas show you." He said, "After 8 years in the White House, I thought maybe that guy was ahead of his time."
Wow.
This is in Bill Clinton's autobiography.
Wow.
This is in his book. There's no way people went on the moon. There's no way.
By the way,
it's impossible today. China wants to go back to the moon. They don't even have a clue how to do it. They're going to try to get there in 2020. America thinks we could possibly go back in 2017. All of the hard data, the telemetry data, 14,000 reels is missing. No one can find it. What the telemetry data
that
is,
amazing?
That's the binary
that
data,
amazing?
The ones and the zeros that show the distance between the command module and the Earth during every step of the way, on the way to the moon and back, which you can't fake. They don't have that. They can't find it, which you would think would be in a locked golden vault in the Smithsonian. But no, they can't find it. Well, they say, "Well, you know, they placed laser reflectors on the moon. You could shoot a laser beam. That's proof." Well, it's not proof, because the Russians did it twice with unmanned probes. The Russians also collected space samples and samples of the moon.
Very amazing, and I've had these guys on. And
which
I've
guys?
Seen, you know, the different guys on the internet that are behind.
There's
the,
a lot of guys, and I've debated that one guy, that Phil Plait from Battlestar. I clown that guy.
The guy that gets in every astronaut's face.
Well, that guy's crazy Christian, and he's nuts. Which is, you know what, you have to be a little crazy to look that deep into this theory, because
wait,
it seems so solid. We went to the moon. It seems so solid.
Joe.
Until you look into it.
But here's the only thing. We can't keep anything quiet in this country.
It doesn't matter. No one's keeping it quiet.
Everybody
you can go
NASA,
look at it.
The astronauts, I mean,
those guys are afraid of their lives. Gus Grissom, the pilot who was the guy who died on the launch pad along with two of his friends, he was a public critic of NASA. He put a lemon, he hung it on the simulator, put a lemon and put it on a hanger and hung it. He was dead in that same cockpit. He died like 2 weeks later. He burned to death inside of that. They were terrified. This is a matter of life and death. These guys were in the middle of a huge Cold War between Russia, and they wanted to show that America had technological superiority. The race to the moon, the moon lay, all that stuff is not about going to the moon and collecting things. It's about military superiority. It's about the ability to do things with military technology. All that stuff they use for NASA, all the stuff they use for the stealth bomber, the space shuttle, all those missions, it's not for philanthropy missions. That's to fuel the military industrial complex. The machine behind this is all the military. And getting to the moon first is making a statement that we have military technological superiority over Russia, and that's what they did.
Is Bigfoot real?
I don't know. You tell me.
You've got a pretty
if you
good,
look into it, man, the
argument.
More you look into it, look, there's
argument.
Photo. Every photograph of the moon looks goofy. There's intersecting shadows that show more than one light source. And you can try to explain any one of these things away, which many people do.
Joe,
the problem is when you look at them all together.
Joe, we're not on for 10 hours.
Man cow.
There's no way people went on the moon. There's no way. There's no way people went on the moon. There's no way.
Neil Tyson, thank you very much for coming on here, man. This is an honor. This is a blast. I think the universe is going to explode. You are, for sure, the most requested podcast guest ever in the history of this podcast. So Brian and I have been doing this for 3 years, and we have come full cycle with your appearance here today.
Right.
Like you're very important. I don't know if you know how important like the cool guy scientist is.
I can't tell you how
many
times.
Very important.
No, so I have I have evidence of how important that is.
You know, I think one of the cool things about you and your approach to science is, I think it's very refreshing that if someone doesn't know something, you're not condescending about it. You're very enthusiastic about distributing the information, but you're not casting a judgment while you do that. And that is something that I think has freaked a lot of people out about really intelligent people or scientists or someone who talks about anything where they have no experience. There's a sort of a condescending sort of a carrying of that knowledge that you don't have.
Now, you were a moon guy for a while, right?
Yeah, I was. Listen, listen, my issues with not believing that people went on the moon, a lot of it had to do with a friend who had an uncle who worked at Rocketdyne. This guy was convinced that there was no way to do it. He was an engineer. And he said they were so far away from doing it that the fact that they did it, and they did it seven times, but since looking at it, the weight of all the evidence, I reserve the possibility that some things were horseshit based on a lot of photographic evidence that they did fuck with.
Well, here's
the
thing.
Gemini photos.
Yeah, but here it is. Here it is. If you look at like the fuel that was loaded up into the Saturn V rocket, you can calculate where that fuel could take that rocket. It's to the moon and back. So they're not going to the Piggly Wiggly, right, yeah, in the Saturn V.
No, I'm a retard. Listen, if anybody has any real sense, they would look at it and say there's no way that that was a hoax. There's no way that that was a hoax.
There's no way people went on the moon. There's no way people went on the moon. There's no way.
See? Honestly, moon landing shit, was it real? Was it not? It was not in the back of my mind.
Yeah, it wasn't in mine, but I forgot that Russell's a moon guy. Look, I've argued with people, and I absolutely don't know. I don't know. I don't believe.
Joe, there was, you were totally down for, you were the moon hoax crusader.
Here's my issue. My issue is, how can I even argue it? How is it possible that I even have points?
Joe,
how is it possible that anybody
could
have any
points? Moon.
You see Breezy right there? Fucking all this shit.
I hope someone did go to the moon. I hope someone did. I really do. I don't know if they didn't.
I had this feeling, man, because you know there's a handful of people actually run everything. That's true. It's provable. I'm not a conspiracy nut. Handful, a very small elite running on these corporations, which include the mainstream media. I had this feeling who's ever elected president, like Clinton was, no matter what you promise on the campaign trail, blah, blah, blah. When you win, you go into this smoky room with the 12 industrialist, capitalist scumfucks who got you in there, and you're in this smoky room, and this little film, a screen comes down, and a big guy in a cigar, roll the film. And it's a shot of a Kennedy assassination from an angle you've never seen before that looks suspiciously off the grassy knoll. And then the film, the screen goes up and the lights come up and they go to the new president. Any questions? Just what my agenda is. 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 Just what my agenda is.
Go back to bed, America. Your government is in control. Here's Love Connection. Watch this and get fat and stupid. By the way, keep drinking beer, you fucking morons.
You fucking morons.
You fucking morons.
You fucking morons.
So Steve Jobs is dead. Steve Jobs is dead. He looks pretty active. Healthy, robust, charismatic. And Stephen Hawking is still alive. I guess it pays to keep your mouth shut and do what you're told. That's amazing, eh? Smartest man alive. Holds all the answers about our universe and outer space. And how it works. And he's also the least likely to go up in a rocket to check out his theories.
Yeah. Sooner or later, the people in this country are going to realize the government does not give a fuck about them. Government doesn't care about you or your children or your rights or your welfare or your safety. It simply doesn't give a fuck about you. It's interested in its own power. That's the only thing, keeping it and expanding it wherever possible.
The interesting thing about this country is they talk about how we have freedom of choice. Uh-huh. You know, we have freedom of choice. Yeah. Very limited. If it's an important thing, limited choice. Two political parties, essentially, two. Big media companies, five, mm-hmm. six.
Max.
Yeah. Oil companies down to three now, I think, overall, three or four. Banks, the big brokerage houses, the big accounting firms. All of the things that are important reduced in choice. Newspapers in a city, how many? Used to be three, four. Now it's one or two. They're owned by the same people, and they also own a radio station and a TV station. But jelly beans, 32 flavors. Ice cream, all the things that don't matter. The unimportant things, a lot of choices. Yeah. I mean, you know what I say? You know what your freedom of choice is in America? Paper or plastic.
Yeah.
That's it, man. It comes down to paper or plastic, cash or charge, aisle or window, smoking or non-smoking, Coke or Pepsi. These are your choices. Everything else is kind of laid out for you. You get to do what they really want. They do what they want. The ones who own this country, they do what they want.
Hello, I'm Bill Hicks, and I'm standing at the foot of one of the halls of justice in our great country. You know, when the producers of this video asked me to discuss my opinions on the George Bush administration, I was struck by the very cynical thought, what is the fucking point? People still love Ronald Reagan. After 8 years of lies and hypocrisy, people love this guy. Leads me to a very disturbing question. How far up your ass does this guy's dick have to be before you realize he's fucking you? People are just, I like Ronald Reagan. He looks good on TV. He made the country stronger. Patriotism's at an all-time high. Hold on a minute, something's slapping my ass. Hey, he's fucking us. What's the point of George Bush? Reagan light. No one cared that he was the ex-head of the CIA, now elected president. The CIA, political assassinations, overthrowing governments, death squads, drug running. Let's give them more power. What is the point? People are already saying, I like George Bush. He looks good on TV. He brought back family values. He's fighting the war on drugs. Wait a minute. Something's slapping my ass. Hey! He's fucking us!
I have no illusions about these cocksuckers. I know there's 12 guys who run the fucking world, and they own every company, and, you know, it's fact. You can look it up. I'm not a conspiracy nut. This is all on paper. There really are 22 families who run and own 50% of the mainstream media, which is where we get our news. And it's true. It's a fact. You can look it up. I don't, you know, I can't be this big of an asshole without having the truth to back me up. Otherwise, I'd be a fucking nut doing this. But see, if you have the truth with you, you can do this.
This is an amazing monumental sort of feat of space exploration. This is the Galileo satellite. Full authentic NASA imagery of the Galileo satellite. Must have cost like $1 trillion for this fucking operation. Very expensive. This is the Galileo satellite. They never knew it would go that far and reach Jupiter. You know, they didn't know. It's the first time anything goes that far. It managed to get there. There's Jupiter. There's one of its moons. I mean, it's clearly lining up to take some really good photos of Jupiter. Immediately followed by a camera satellite. Perfectly composing the whole shot out in outer space. Amazing, eh? What the cameras could do when they fly. It's into outer space, a place we've never been to. That's amazing. Look at that. That is perfect. That's like the photo of the year, if you ask me. For a fucking satellite to be able to, like, you know, like wake up in outer space. We didn't even know we could do that, you know, and unbelievable. I give it to NASA. Let's go to another photo here. Another photo. This is good, too. Oh, let's zoom in. I love that iMovie sort of effect. I'm really in the gas. But how am I supposed to go? Yeah, that's the Earth. From there, that point of view I've never seen. And it's funny when you click on Google Images, photo of the Earth, keep going. Because this is realistic. But you'll see 40 pages on Google. But it's always the same fucking photo. It's the same photo. They just changed the contrast. Check it out, keep going. Oh yeah, boom, 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 40 pages. Look closely. It's always the same. Oh, what is that? I guess this is a photo of the Hubble telescope taking a picture of itself. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. That's an authentic photo of the Hubble telescope out there doing its job. Isn't that amazing how they could take a photo of the thing taking photos? Out in outer space. Unbelievable. You know, they never crossed Antarctica, but let's go to the moon and take pictures of shit out in space. That's fucking unbelievable. You know, the instruments won't work in Antarctica. It's too fucking cold. But hey, let's go somewhere where we don't know the instruments will work. That's unbelievable. It just boggles my mind how they do this stuff. All right, next one. Solar powered, by the way. Solar powered. Look at that. Environmental. Environmental in outer space. Okay. That's my only fucking fan right there. Naomi. There's it. There you go. There you go. There's what you believe. That's it. That's it. That point of view you've never seen. It's fucking funny, huh? I think it's funny. You've never seen that, but everybody goes, yeah. Il prend ça pour acquis. Ah oui, c'est ça. L'affaire que j'ai jamais vue. It's funny, eh? You should think about these things, right? I heard that, you know, if you want to, like, program a human mind, what you do is you just repeat images to a young child while the brain is forming.
Well,
yeah, pretty much. And then, you know, the kid fucking grows up, and you've wired the kid. It's fucking mind control. It's great. But it's an example. Hey, I could be wrong. I could be wrong. There could have been a camera rocket that got there on the moon, set up, pulled out, like, a lens, and then filmed it. And process 35 millimeter black and white film in an atmosphere. We don't know if cameras will work. All right, so anyways, next photo. Hey, it's possible. Those guys are so ahead. They don't tell us, right? There you go again. Same fucking thing, same cloud patterns, always the same cloud patterns.
Don't forget your flag of the world has no Antarctica and it's flat. But of course, to entertain that notion, you have to be an idiot. Right? Like they told you, Simon says. Well, I'm going to run you guys through a perception test to see if this crowd could discern between an image that's a painting by applause, or a photo of reality. So by applause, how many people think this is a painting? By applause, how many people think this is a photo? It's a photo of a painting, but that's not the fucking argument. Next. It's a painting. Photo or painting? By applause, photo. By applause, painting. It's a painting by the artist photorealist Cesar Santander. Photo or painting? Painting. That's the photo. How do I know? I did it. Pause. Painting or photo? By applause, photo. By applause, painting. That's a photo. It looks like a painting. Photo or painting? Painting. I did it. Pause. Photo or painting? Photo? By applause. By applause, painting. You're just fucking crap shooting in the casino now, aren't you? Painting, Richard Estes. Photo or painting? By applause, photo? That's a photo. Next. And that's my painting of the photo. Photo or painting? Photo? Pause. Photo or painting?
Photo.
Painting.
Painting.
Painting, I did it.
I fucking did it. I own the copyright on all this shit.
Pause. That's why I can monetize on YouTube. By the way, I own the NASA channel on YouTube. I swear to God. That's an official photo from NASA. By applause, how many people think that's a photo? By applause, how many people think this is bullshit? This is all the Olympia, distant moon of Mercury. This is all Olympia without the shading from Adobe Photoshop. Good look at it. And this is the little section from an ice inlet in
in the Antarctic that I cut out, and I just cropped the fucking black circle out of construction paper and made a planet out of it. Oh, this is Pupipipia. This is a distant planet of Venus. As you can see here, you can see all the crater textures on my shirt. We can fucking make you think. Oh, this is amazing. These are supernovas. They never caught this many suns colliding and actually exploding at the same time by Hubble telescope. And actually, I have a close-up of this. Amazing. This is actually the most distant shot they have of our galaxy. Here's a close-up. They came up with a new term for this, collisionary supernovas, because suns were actually meeting and exploding at the same time. In a Christmas tree. This guy's pretty smart right there. This is Mars. This is the surface of Mars. Yeah. Very sandy. Surface of Mars without the black background. There you go. It's just the desert. Oh, this is sunrise. On Star Trek. It's a Hollywood image that looks real. Now, photo of painting. 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 How the fuck would you know? This is actual NASA. Here, pause. You see this cloud formation there? You see, like, you see Africa? Do you see the shadow line on the top of Africa? Next image. They fucking reversed it. Our boys at NASA, they took the same image, they just flipped it. They flipped it, and they call it two different images. I'm not making this shit up.
America's leading industry is still the manufacture, distribution, packaging, and marketing of bullshit. High-quality bullshit. World-class designer bullshit, to be sure. Hospital-tested, clinically proven bullshit. But bullshit nonetheless. And it always amuses me that so many people seem to think that bullshit only comes from certain sources. You know, advertising, politicians, salesmen. Not true. Bullshit is everywhere. Bullshit is rampant. Parents are full of shit. Teachers are full of shit. Clergymen are full of shit. Law enforcement people are full of shit. The entire country is completely full of shit. In fact, this country was founded by a group of slave owners who told us that all men are created equal. That is what's known as being stunningly, stunningly full of shit. And you know, I think... And I think people show their ignorance when they say they want politicians to be honest. What are these people talking about? If honesty were suddenly introduced into politics, it would throw everything off. The whole system would collapse. And I think deep down the American people know that. The American people like their bullshit out front, where they can get a good strong whiff of it. That's why they reelected Clinton. Listen. Clinton might be full of shit, but he lets you know it. Dole tried to hide it. I'm an honest man. Bullshit. Bullshit. People don't believe that shit. Clinton said, "Hi, I'm full of shit, and how do you like that?" And the people said, "At least he's honest. At least he's honest about being full of shit." It's like the business world. All businessmen are completely full of shit. Just the worst kind of people you could ever want to run into. Businessmen. And the proof of it is, they don't even trust each other. They don't trust each other. When a businessman is negotiating a deal, the first thing he does is to automatically assume that the other guy is a complete lying prick who's trying to fuck him on the deal. So he has to do everything he can to fuck the other guy a little bit harder and a little bit faster. And then, when it comes to dealing with customers, that's when you get the big smile. That's when you get the big smile. Businessman always has that big smile on his face as he carefully positions himself directly behind the customer and unzips his pants and services the account. We specialize in customer service. You heard that? Now you know what it means. Whoever coined the phrase, let the buyer beware, was probably bleeding from the asshole.
Okay, so here's the picture of the Earth from space. There it is. Since you were a kid, you've seen this image. But you've never seen it from that point of view. You've never seen that with your eyes from that scale of a model, that point of view, from outside of the planet's surface. But your brain has three-dimensionalized, oh yeah, that's the Earth. How? Through repetition. Next image. How do we get to this point of the image? This is fucking funny. I think this is funny. Next image. Well, here's the first image that sold the whole thing. As you can see, that's clearly the universe. I mean, that's clearly the universe. I swear to God. I mean, there's the sun. I mean, I could recognize that thing. It's a bullseye. It's like a planet. It's an egg. Whatever. But there you go. You got each rung, the whole thing. 1482. This is when they came up with this idea. We are on that thing. It's a ball. Hey, we should go to the North and the South Pole. We didn't do it yet. It's a fucking ball. Hey, nobody's even like jumped up high enough to see if it is a ball. You can't do that. We don't have planes yet. It's a ball. You know what? We adopted this whole model like 400 or 500 years before the airplane. 400 years before the airplane, pretty much. It was like beginning of the 1900s. They went to the North Pole in the 1900s. This is 1482. Nobody went to the top of the globe, to the bottom, or flew up, or built a skyscraper. That's it. It's been a decade since, like, Columbus hit America. That's it. You had Spinoza, Leibniz. Everybody was fighting to say what the fuck we were on, how much land there really was. Real estate, right? Real estate. The only commodity that appreciates besides art. Right? These are the only things that appreciate. Everything's depreciating except those two. It's funny how these two are going to meet and what I'm going to talk about. Next image. It's funny that we said that this is what we're in right now. This is what we're on before any instrument approved. Until, boss, can you do it? It's funny, back in the 60s when they went to the moon, this is the first time we actually had like an instrument of flight to actually go high enough to actually fucking check out if what we agreed to 500 years ago was real. So if they were wrong after 500 years, the question is, would they tell you?
Well, people are going to go, well, here's some footage of the Earth rotating, liar. So you got like, you can't see very well here with the light here, but you got like South America turning here. But what's interesting here is has this image been doctored by applause? Yes or no? Has it been doctored? Yeah, it's been sped up because South America at this speed is going to be around in 5 minutes. But what's interesting is the clouds are not morphing. Oh, it's spinning, but the artists are too lazy to show how fast the clouds will be morphing at that speed. Check it out. See that cluster of clouds? It's not fucking changing. And that's a real shot of the Earth spinning, but the clouds aren't changing. People go to me, what are you on? What did you fucking smoke? What drugs did you take?
I have certain rules I live by. My first rule, I don't believe anything the government tells me. Nothing. Zero. And I gotta tell you folks, I don't get all choked up about yellow ribbons and American flags. I consider them to be symbols, and I leave symbols to the symbol-minded.
Give these people a voting day every year so that they'll have the illusion of meaningless choice. Meaningless choice that we go like slaves and say, yo, I voted. The limits of debate in this country are established before the debate even begins, and everyone else is marginalized and made to seem either to be communists or some sort of disloyal person. A kook, there's a word. And now it's conspiracy. See, they've made that something that should not be even entertained for a minute, that powerful people might get together and have a plan. Doesn't happen. You're a kook. You're a conspiracy buff.
I think the puppet on the right shares my beliefs. I think the puppet on the left is more to my liking. Hey, wait a minute. There's one guy holding up both puppets. Shut up.
Go back to bed, America. Your government is in control.
Here's Love Connection. Watch this and get fat and stupid. By the way, keep drinking beer, you fucking morons.
Go back to bed, America. Here is American Gladiators. Here is 56 channels of it. Watch these pituary retards bang their fucking skulls together and congratulate you on living in the land of freedom. Here you go, America. You are free to do as we tell you. You are free to do as we tell you.
Everybody's at the mall. Scratching his ass, picking his nose, taking his credit card out of his fanny pack and buying a pair of sneakers with lights in them. So I have solved this little political dilemma for myself in a very simple way. On election day, I stay home. I don't vote. Fuck them. Fuck them. I don't vote. Two reasons I don't vote. First of all, it's meaningless. This country was bought, sold, and paid for a long time ago. The shit they shuffle around every 4 years doesn't mean a fucking thing.
Jim, calm down. You began a sentence a little while ago with it's not a surprise. It shouldn't be a surprise. It shouldn't be a surprise that rich white men don't care about poor black people, period. So they're not high on their list. They're not high on their list.
George, they're I love not you, high. George, not, that's
I don't
nonsense.
Care if you love me or not.
That's
they're
nonsense.
Not high on the conscious or the subconscious list of those people who are in charge of things in this country. The owners, forget these foolish elections. The owners of this country don't care about the poor in general.
The owners
and they
of this
don't
country.
Care about
what are we going? Is this Karl Marx talking to me? The owners of this country are
no.
the voters of this
no,
country.
You're wrong about that, my friend.
Aren't the owners of this country
wrong.
The voters in this country
no,
who
no,
elected
they're,
George
no,
Bush?
No, they're not. Listen, politics, these elections are a charade. It is a charade.
Oh, okay.
It is. They are meant to... Well, I'll tell you, listen, just listen for a minute. Learn a little something. The elections and politicians are in place in order to give Americans the illusion that they have freedom of choice. Oh. You don't really have choice in this country. The real looting in this country takes place in the transfer of the wealth from the poor to the rich. I'm sorry that you don't like class and the truth, my friend, but you're just stuck with it. And the poor have been systematically looted in this country. The rich have been made richer under this criminal, fascist president and his government.
George, I think you know. Do you know what fascism is?
Fascism,
you know what fascism
when it comes
is?
To America,
you know what Nazis
wear,
are?
Not wear, no, wait,
yeah.
sir, wait,
you
sir. When
Nazis
fascism
are?
Comes
you know
to America,
fascists
it will not
are?
Be in brown and black shirts. It will not be with jack boots. It will be Nike sneakers and smiley shirts. Smiley. The fascism... Germany lost the Second World War. Fascism won it. Believe
and actually,
me, my friend.
Fascism is when corporations become the government.
Do you remember when Pluto was a planet?
Yeah.
What happened to that shit? We were at 9 planets, and now we're at 8? Like, and everybody's like, huh, okay, we were off on our solar system. We're not 9 planets, we're 8. That's fucked up. I'm sorry. I noticed that. Everybody else went back to bed. You know, like we're saying, it's 9 planets going around the sun. And then suddenly, like, in the year 2000, what? 7, 8? After fucking Y2K, we fucked up. Pluto's not a planet. That's, no. You don't fuck up on planets. You can't fucking tell me for 500 years that there's 9 fucking planets and then just try to slip it in the Yahoo front page. We discovered Pluto's too small to be a planet. Sorry, we fucked up. There's only 8. Like, come on, you can't just do that and I go, and suck my thumb and, you know, eat your fucking shit pablum. There's no fucking way. What about the guy who works at NASA and he just studied Pluto? That's all he fucking learned. He went to university. This poor sucker. What's he doing now? He's fucking on the street, penniless. There's nothing to do. He just studied one fucking planet. You know how they get become specific in their physics and they study a planet from a picture they'd never fucking seen? They're like, I'm an expert on Jupiter, man. I know Mercury inside out. I fucking find out the news. It's like, what are you doing here, man? Well, I came in for work. Dude, didn't you hear the news? What? Pluto's not a planet, man. You were off, man. You were fucking way off. It's a moon. You screwed up. It's too small. Well, the light emissions were big enough to be called a planet. Because apparently, that light in the sky, they were saying, was that picture they've been feeding was Pluto. Suddenly one day, diminished rapidly. So they had to come up with something real fucking quick, because that thing they fucking pointed at the sky, that's Pluto. That's moving around. It's like, oh, suddenly one day everybody's like, hey, what happened to the light on Pluto? It's like, did that bulb go out? And then there was a big debate. Well, we can't decide whether it's a planet based on how much light we see. This is ridiculous. You got to give us more to work on. Like a rocket that sends us there to check out to see if it's big enough to be a fucking planet. You know, like, nobody's going out of this shit. They're just taking NASA's... I mean, one day NASA could come out and say something on fucking Yahoo and we'd all be, like, repeating it. Like, we'd just be like, yeah. It's like, we found a distant planet off the distant moon Io of Jupiter. And I'd be like, wait a minute, are you saying... There'd be a bunch of fucking Star Trek physics nerds at NASA going, wait a minute, are you saying that moons can have their own planets? That's fucking crazy. You saying planets can revolve around moons now? Oh my God, planets can revolve around moons! And they'd be flipping out. Moons have planets too, man. It just keeps going.
Showbiz is completely dishonest, corrupt, and full of shit, but in a nice way. Plenty of expensive drugs and perverted sex. If you're gonna be full of shit, might as well enjoy your work. Then you have the media. Not just the news media, let's include them all. The media are almost literally exploding with bullshit. Because they're located right at the crossroads of all the other bullshit. The media are made up of equal parts advertising, politics, business, public relations, and show business. These people are sitting right at bullshit junction. There's enough bullshit in the media for Texas to open a branch office. And you still have enough left over to start 2 law firms and a Christian bookstore. My mind doesn't work that way. I got this real moron thing I do. It's called thinking. And I'm not a very good American because I like to form my own opinions. I don't just roll over when I'm told to. Sad to say, most Americans just roll over on command. Not me. I have certain rules I live by. My first rule, I don't believe anything the government tells me. Nothing. Zero. Nope. And I don't take very seriously the media or the press in this country, who in the case of the Persian Gulf War were nothing more than unpaid employees of the Department of Defense, and who most of the time function as kind of an unofficial public relations agency for the United States government. So I don't listen to them, I don't really believe in my country, and I gotta tell you folks, I don't get all choked up about yellow ribbons and American flags.
Everything's a lie. Government's lying to you about everything. Oh, no, not the moon landing. Oh, no. Don't take that one from us, too. That's the easiest one for me to take. They didn't go to the moon to go to the moon. They went to the moon so they could get the picture of the Earth as a ball. Because they didn't have one yet. And it was starting to get a little tense in the higher chambers. You say 2,000 years it's a ball and you don't even have a picture to show for it. But how could you have a picture just to, you know, they had those. They needed the event to actually get the a real picture. And there's just so few of those pictures when you actually look at them. And most of them. George Lucas or like Stanley Kubrick could have done. Or I could do. Or you could see a guy in the street with a spray can and a circle cut out of cardboard making planets.
Now there's one thing you might have noticed I don't complain about. Politicians. Everybody complains about politicians. Everybody says they suck.
Yeah.
Well, where do people think these politicians come from? They don't fall out of the sky. They don't pass through a membrane from another reality. They come from American parents and American families, American homes, American schools, American churches, American businesses, and American universities, and they're elected by American citizens. This is the best we can do, folks. This is what we have to offer. It's what our system produces. Garbage in, garbage out. If you have selfish, ignorant citizens, you're going to get selfish, ignorant leaders. And term limits ain't going to do you any good. You're just going to wind up with a brand new bunch of selfish, ignorant Americans. So maybe it's not the politicians who suck. Maybe something else sucks around here, like the public. Yeah, the public sucks. There's a nice campaign slogan for somebody. The public sucks. Fuck hope. Fuck hope. Because if it's really just the fault of these politicians, then where are all the other bright people of conscience? Where are all the bright, honest, intelligent Americans ready to step in and save the nation and lead the way? We don't have people like that in this country. Everybody's at the mall.
I'm Jason Calabrese with the Financial News, and today we're talking to a real Irishman and someone in the money business about what's going on in Ireland with the Celtic Tiger and the banks are hurting so much, the downfall. What's the story here?
Do you really want to know?
I'd love to know.
Well, I'll tell you, it's like what has happened all over the Western world for the last 20 or 30 years. Greed, greed, and more fucking greed, and cheap money. And in Ireland, it's a tragedy what happened to the Tiger. We have, I'd say, four causes. We had a stupid fucking government. We had a regulator that was asleep at the wheel. And we had very deceitful and conniving and corrupt developers. And, of course, above all, wanking fucking bankers. Wanking bankers. We had these arseholes that for the last 20, 30 years are getting these massive bonuses, these employees and directors of banks, on the misfortune of the working class and getting these huge bonuses and salaries. But, you know, if you and all these arseholes should be thrown in jail and the keys thrown away for the rest of their life. And, you know, sir, if you went in and you're unemployed and you wanted to take a loaf of bread out of a store or a supermarket to feed your family, guess what? You'll be up in court for it. These assholes are living all over the world now on the backs of the misfortunate working people. And who's going to pay for all this? We've mortgaged the next generation or two. Who's going to pay for it? The working man. We got the labourer, the small farmer, the fisherman, the nurse, the teacher, the policeman, the fireman, the plumber, the carpenter. Fuck's sake, man. This is a joke.
So I'm sensing a wee bit of discontent?
You are indeed, sir. And by the way, let's not be too cocky in this part of the world, North America either. All these debts that people have accumulated over the last 30 years, hey, everybody gets their day in the sunshine.
Not too bright, folks. Not too fucking bright. But if you talk to one of them about this, if you isolate one of them, you sit them down rationally, and you talk to them about the low IQs and the dumb behavior and the bad decisions, right away they start talking about education. That's the big answer to everything. Education. They said we need more money for education. We need more books, more teachers, more classrooms, more schools. We need more testing for the kids. You say to them, well, you know, we've tried all of that, and the kids still can't pass the tests. They say, oh, don't you worry about that. We're going to lower the passing grades. And that's what they do in a lot of these schools now. They lower the passing grades so more kids can pass. More kids pass, the school looks good, everybody's happy, the IQ of the country slips another 2 or 3 points, and pretty soon all you'll need to get into college is a fucking pencil. Got a pencil? Get the fuck in there. It's physics. Then everyone wonders why 17 other countries graduate more scientists than we do. Education! Politicians know that word. They use it on you. Politicians have traditionally hidden behind three things. The flag, the Bible, and children. No child left behind. No child left behind. Oh, really? Well, it wasn't long ago you were talking about giving kids a head start. Head start? Left behind? Someone's losing fucking ground here.
But there's a reason. There's a reason. There's a reason for this. There's a reason education sucks, and it's the same reason that it will never, ever, ever be fixed. It's never going to get any better. Don't look for it. Be happy with what you got. Because the owners of this country don't want that. I'm talking about the real owners now. The big, the wealthy, that the real owners, the big wealthy business interests that control things and make all the important decisions. Forget the politicians. They're irrelevant. The politicians are put there to give you the idea that you have freedom of choice. You don't. You have no choice. You have owners. They own you. They own everything. They own all the important land. They own and control the corporations. They've long since bought and paid for the Senate, the Congress, the state houses, the city halls. They got the judges in their back pockets. And they own all the big media news, all the big media companies, so they control just about all of the news and information you get to hear. They got you by the balls. They spend billions of dollars every year lobbying to get what they want. Well, we know what they want. They want more for themselves and less for everybody else. But I'll tell you what they don't want. They don't want a population of citizens capable of critical thinking. They don't want well-informed, well-educated people capable of critical thinking. They're not interested in that. That doesn't help them. That's against their interest. That's right. You know something? They don't want people who are smart enough to sit around the kitchen table to figure out how badly they're getting fucked by a system that threw them overboard 30 fucking years ago. They don't want that. You know what they want? They want obedient workers. Obedient workers. People who are just smart enough to run the machines and do the paperwork and just dumb enough to passively accept all these increasingly shittier jobs with the lower pay, the longer hours, the reduced benefits, the end of overtime, and the vanishing pension that disappears the minute you go to collect it. And now they're coming for your Social Security money. They want your fucking retirement money. They want it back. So they can give it to their criminal friends on Wall Street. And you know something? They'll get it. They'll get it all from you sooner or later because they own this fucking place. It's a big club and you ain't in it. You and I are not in the big club. And by the way, it's the same big club they use to beat you over the head with all day long when they tell you what to believe. All day long, beating you over the head in their media, telling you what to believe, what to think, and what to buy. The table is tilted, folks. The game is rigged. And nobody seems to notice. Nobody seems to care. Good, honest, hardworking people, white collar, blue collar, doesn't matter what color shirt you have on. Good, honest, hardworking people continue. These are people of modest means. Continue to elect these rich cocksuckers who don't give a fuck about them. They don't give a fuck about you. They don't give a fuck about you. They don't care about you at all. At all. At all. Yeah. You know? And nobody seems to notice, nobody seems to care. That's what the owners count on, the fact that Americans will probably remain willfully ignorant of the big red, white, and blue dick that's being jammed up their assholes every day. Because the owners of this country know the truth. It's called the American dream, because you have to be asleep to believe it. There's just enough bullshit to hold things together in this country. Bullshit is the glue that binds us as a nation. Where would we be without our safe, familiar American bullshit? Land of the free, home of the brave, the American dream. All men are equal, justice is blind, the press is free, your vote counts. Business is honest, the good guys win, the police are on your side. God is watching you, your standard of living will never decline, and everything is gonna be just fine. The official national bullshit story. I call it the American okey-doke. Every one of those items is provably untrue at one level or another, but we believe them because they're pounded into our heads from the time we're children. That's what they do with that kind of stuff. They put it in the heads of kids. They pound it in there because kids, they know kids are too young to be able to mount a sophisticated argument against these kind of ideas. And so kids, and up to a certain age, by the way, kids are going to believe everything a grown-up tells them. Everything. So kids never learn to question things. Nobody questions things in this country anymore. Nobody questions things. Why? People are too fat and happy. People are way too fucking prosperous for their own good. Everyone's got a cell phone that'll make pancakes and rub their balls now, you know? So nobody wants to rock the boat. And people just, Americans have been silenced, bought off and silenced by gizmos and toys. And as a result, no one's ever learned to question things. Children who want to read are going to read. Kids who want to learn to read are going to learn to read. Much more important to teach children to question what they read. Children should be taught to question everything. To question everything they read everything they hear. Children should be taught to question authority. Parents never teach their children to question authority because parents are authority figures themselves and they don't want to undermine their own bullshit inside the household. So they stroke the kid and the kid strokes them and they all stroke each other and they all grow up all fucked up and they come to shows like this.
A real fetus. Whether the earth is a ball. You want to have a fight? You want to go to war with Russia? We're going to have a real fight in 2015. Like, gentlemen, your evidence, I ask you where it's from, and you let me cross Antarctica with rope and spikes from any entry point with my team. I'm wrong, you can laugh at me. You have CNN and MSNBC waiting for me on the other coastline. If it's a ball, the earth's a ball, then you should be set up with camera crews for the most humiliating, comical event in the history of man. It's a guy who's so smart, so sure that you're lying, and he's wrong, and you're gonna catch it on film when he comes across Antarctica on the other coastline. But I'm not. Let me. That's why you've given sanction and exclusive rights to the Extreme World Race organization based out of London, England, to allow people to do expeditions or cross. That's why every person who goes into Antarctica is either a UN operative or a shill of one of those, you know, scientific bodies underneath the Antarctic Treaty Project. I mean, poor Jarl Andahoy, he didn't even know what he was getting into. He jumped the fence. Look what happened to Jarl Andahoy. I think it's Y-A-R-L. No, J-A-R-L-E. Andahoy, N-A-N-D-E-H-O-Y. Go look at what happened to him. He still doesn't get it. Poor Viking. You want to have a fight? Let's have a real fight. The flat earth against the ball. That's the fight. That's the fight they don't want you to have. That's the fight they don't want you to entertain in your head. That's the fight they don't want you to entertain in your mind. Whether the images of the earth as a ball are fake.